Well, howdy, 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 folks. I am glad to be here. Hope you are too. It is Thursday, and I know I said I'd do this yesterday, and I just didn't have time. You know, one thing led to another. Neighbor's chicken was having puppies. You know, excuses, excuses. Oh, let me turn this off here. This stupid thing is going, and that's going to mess us up. Every time I forget to do that, but it's the only way I know if the sound's going through. So, I'm excited to be here because I got an email. I read you a piece of it the other day, 2 days ago, and this is a family that has lucky dogs, and I'm going to show you. Let me see if I can pull this up real quick. Here's Lucky Dogz. I'm going to step out of the way. That's Lucky Dogz there. They do catering and stuff, but I'm going to read you their email. That's a Cater Pro they're working on there, and they've just added lemonade. And holy cow, it's taken them to a whole nother level, but they were already kicking butt, and you'll see that here in the email. Let me read this to you real quick. All right, so it says, "Hi, Ben. Thought I would check in with you and let you know our success. My husband, Tony, and I began with the hot dog business and purchased the Cater Pro. We have been doing very well with it. Our focus was working horse shows that our daughter competes in. These types of shows these types of shows rarely have food. The shows run 3 days where we work 4 to 5 hours a day. We have been averaging $2,200 for each show. We have also expanded to community events." Okay. We then, and you can see from the setup there, how freaking sexy. They've got a nice setup, and I'll pull you another picture in here to look at. Let's see here. Here's a good one from a view from a distance, kind of. And you can see both their setups there. There's the Lucky Dogz hot dogs, and then I think that's the lemonade there right now. On this one, that's a local car show, right? So let me finish this. We then added lemonade, and it has made us $1,200 at least, a minimum of $1,200 a day. We charge now, obviously this is the days they work, not every day, just by sitting home watching Oprah or Andy Griffith reruns, they're not making $1,200. It's the days they work. So we charge $6 for a 32-ounce cup of plain lemonade and $8 a cup for flavored lemonade. Okay, so our flavors are strawberry, mango, pineapple, and raspberry. If a customer wants to add more than one fruit flavor, then each additional fruit flavor is one more dollar. We use all fruit, no syrups. Now, I'm not done reading you this email, so bear with me, okay? I do want to say good morning to everybody. I'm glad you're here. Scott, Humberto's here. Reggie, Andy, Max is here. Scott Painter's here. Nancy Wallace is here. Good morning from Jamestown, Tennessee. I know exactly where that'd be. I've got some cousins live in Jamestown. So, howdy, 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 Ben. This is John with Doghouse Dogz. Glad you're here. I want to sell biscuits and coffee in the morning and in the afternoon, burgers and dogs. Humberto, go to learnhotdogs.com, type in the word breakfast in the search box. You'll pull up a vendor I interviewed that does exactly that. He does breakfast sandwiches, biscuits, like sausage biscuits, sausage, egg, and cheese biscuits, just cheese biscuits, whatever you want. And he's already got them pre-wrapped. He makes them in the commissary, keeps them on the steam table to keep them hot. And he's got coffee AirPods on his big dog cart. And now he's expanded, so he's got this shelf set up with even more coffees. He kicks butt. He stumbled into that gig. Stumbled into it, okay? It was on the side of the road, and he just showed up early. He was near a business area and a business park, and where all these people go into work every day at 8 or 9 in the morning. And he showed up early one day, and somebody said, "Do you have coffee?" And he's like, "No, I'm setting up for lunch." And they were like, "Oh, man, you should have coffee." So he started bringing coffee and getting there a little earlier. That exploded into a whole breakfast menu, and he quit doing lunch altogether. It's a cool deal. Look here, Scott says, looking to start catering after the farmer's market season is over. Absolutely. Catering is kicking butt. Catering is kicking butt for so many vendors, and not the typical catering. If you want to know more about the catering, learnhotdogs.com and just type in the word cater or catering, and you'll find all you want to know. And I've got a free course in there. There's all kinds of stuff for you so that you can grab that. But today, I'm talking about lemonade because it's freaking August, one of the hottest months of the year, July and August, and there is a ton of money to be made in lemonade. Ton of money. And then you get into the colder months and you switch over to apple cider, you know, and cinnamon cider and all that cool stuff. So, let's see. Let me finish this email. Okay. I got to finish this email and then I'm going to show you some more pictures. So one example, I'm reading this word for word. One example of our success was the 3rd of July in our own community. It's an evening event. We had both hot dogs and lemonade running. We hired our daughter and two of her friends to do the lemonade side. In just 3 hours, we made $2,600 plus tips in 3 hours. It was crazy 3 hours with never-ending lines, which was great. She's got great in capital. We had hit the ground running that day. The event did not give vendors much time to set up. For the only reason we stopped serving that night was because we had not had the time to put up lights and we were in the dark. So they're saying if they'd have stayed and had lights, they could have even sold more, but they just had to leave because it was dark. And I guess other vendors had lights. They didn't have lights. So, but look what they did already. 3 hours with lemonade, $2,600 plus tips at a local community event. Now, a recent car show, and you should see that picture right there, right? A recent car show, we made $2,568 in 3 hours. We had a rough start as we had troubles towing the trailer and we had a hot dog cart and it set us back in time. So they had some issues getting the cart there. Our daughter and her friend were able to leave early and got the lemonade going. The trailering of the hot dog cart was extremely stressful, but better late than never, and we still did amazing. So even though they ran into some obstacles, they sent their daughter on and to set up the lemonade and started making money, and then they got the cart there and got it set up, right? Since that night, our daughter, who is 18 years old, on her way to her first year of college, congratulations, by the way, this is Colleen and Tony. And Colleen's the one that wrote me, but Colleen and Tony with Lucky Dogz Hot Dogs and Catering and now Lucky Lemonade. Okay, so since that night, our daughter, who is going off to college, saw the potential of selling lemonade, she is taking that side of the business over. She now hires her friends, trains them, and pays them a flat rate of $100 a day, and they split the tips. We have told her if she wants to take the lemonade business to college, she is welcome to. Can you imagine setting up outside of the university football games? It would be freaking dazzling. Okay, we've seen vendors do outside, even tailgate parties. We've had some vendors cater for tailgate parties. Like somebody goes, man, I want a tailgate at the UT football game, and I'm going to hire this vendor to come in and set up beside me and my friends and family, we're going to be tailgating hot dog style, you know, because then you can do anything you want. You could serve spaghetti or pulled pork or whatever you want because you're tailgating, even though you're hiring a vendor to come and help you. It is the best thing since sliced bread. And sliced bread's pretty cool because before that, they had to pull it apart and that was a pain in the neck. So the bottom line is congratulations to Colleen and Tony and with Lucky Dogz Hot Dogs and Catering and Lucky Lemonade. And congratulations to their daughter going off to college and going to take the lemonade business with her. What a great way to earn an income through college and a lot of income, as you can see. So I hope that helps you. Now, to help you even more, I have a website called howtostartalemonadebusiness.com. Can't get any easier than that. And it'll walk you step by step. You can grab my free course. It's, I think it's 24 hours to lemonade vending. Shows you how to get started quickly. Okay. Learnhotdogs.com/lemon. You'll find out about more vendors who have just started and are kicking butt. Vendors that have been doing it, kicking butt. I've had on here Ken Packer. Y'all know Packer's Lemonade. Does phenomenal amount of business with lemonade. And you go, well, what about the winter? Don't worry about the winter right now. I got plenty of stuff for the winter. Okay, we got kettle corn coming again. Kettle corn kicks butt in the winter. But I'm telling you, if you want to make a lot of money real quick, with very minimal expense, Okay? Start with lemonade and get going and change your life and go, man, I can do this. And man, I could work just on the weekend or just that one day off a week from my regular job and I could do this. That's how you can do it. I just showed you, what was it, 2 days ago? I think it was Tuesday, right? I showed you Craig, okay? And Craig is Sinclair, and Craig is the one in California that sent me the pictures and all the info for the event he did this past weekend, okay? And he did it without a cart, without anything fancy. He did it with stuff that you probably already have other than maybe a banner or two, but the weekend before that, he didn't even have a banner. And he still did over 10 grand. So, but it was a two-day event. But this event was just a few hours at a swap meet and does over $9,000. That's the kind of stuff you want to see and watch and follow. And you go, oh, well, if Craig can do that in California, in one of the worst counties in California to even get going, why can't I? Well, it's like asking a rhetorical question. Because the answer is a given. There's no reason for you not to change your life. No reason for you to have to be stuck in a rut, that rat race of, you know, running out of money before month, every freaking month. All of us have been there. Don't think you're alone. Don't think you've be the first person that put on Facebook Marketplace, got to sell my kids ride around cart so we can pay our electric bill or make up the rest of the rent payment. You can change all that, every single bit, with no luck involved, okay? The only thing lucky about Lucky Dogz is the name, okay? Or Lucky Lemonade, even. It's just the name. You don't need luck. Y'all have heard my hole digging story, right? Right? Anybody can dig a hole, right? You'd agree, right? I want to get some yeses, all right? So you can dig a hole. Well, even if you never had dug a hole, never seen a hole dug, didn't know what kind of tool to use to dig a hole, you could dig a hole if I showed you the steps to dig a hole. And it's just simple steps, right? I'd say, here's a shovel, okay? And you stick it in the ground. And it's got to be the right kind of ground. You don't stick it into steel or you don't stick it into a rock. Now, you could. It's just going to take you a lot longer. But the point is you do that. And even if you said, well, dang, I didn't follow all the instructions. I still got a hole, but it took me forever. But then I found out later I was using the wrong end of the shovel. Wouldn't matter, right? You'd still get a hole. Take you a lot longer, but you'd get a hole, right? So if I say, okay, get a shovel, piece of ground, stick the shovel in, pull out dirt, now you got a hole. I just showed you how to dig a hole, and you'd be like, oh, you don't need luck for that. You don't need any kind of, you know, magic crow's feathers and jumping on one foot backwards twice and doing some kind of chant with some herb, whatever, smoke in there. You don't need any of that. All you need to do is follow the steps, and I give you those steps right there at learnhotdogs.com/lemon, or you can go to howtostartalemonadebusiness.com, and you can get started now. You can start this business now, and I help you. I'll show you the way so that you're the one emailing me like Colleen did here. She emailed me and said, here's my pictures. Here's what we're doing. Just giving you an update. I get lots of these. I freaking love it. Colleen, I had to email her back and say, hey, can I share this? And she said, absolutely, share away. So let me show you this other picture real quick. Or other pictures. So here's another picture. Hopefully this comes in good. Okay. Now, if you look back there on the right, that's the Cater Pro, but there's the lemonade set up and they've got the drink cups. And then let me go to another one here. I already showed you the car show. This is the one I used for the, well, what? Dang it. Dang it. Dang it. Dang it. Let me get this in here. Boom. Okay, so there's the daughters, or the daughter and a friend, doing lemonade, and there they are shaking it up. So they got a wedger, they got a little table going, and do you see how anybody can do this? And they're getting tips. If I scroll down to the bottom of this, you'd see the tips there, and I may be able to pull that picture in for you if you want to see it. Let me see how it is I do that. Bear with me. Lucky. I saved these under the word lucky so I could find them quick. Okay. I want to see if this helps with the picture. Okay, so there's the whole picture. That gives you an idea. It blew it up on the background, but you see there, that's the whole picture of what they're doing there. And that's what you got to do. That's it. Hey, whoever gave me the thumbs up, thank you. That was sweet. I like those. It boosts my ego, and then my head swells, and I have to widen my door. I had already put in a garage door. Okay, so let me look at some of these questions real quick. Bear with me. Yep, he says, Umberto says, thank you, sir. Continue to do my due diligence. Absolutely. Do your due diligence. Get started. Don't overanalyze. Just do the steps, your due diligence, and get started the right way. That way you don't spend any money you don't need to, but also you can get paralyzed. They call it paralysis from analysis. I've got a buddy like that. I'm one of these shoot first, aim later types, which is dangerous, right? And then I've got a buddy, a good friend of mine, who is the, well, let me analyze this. I'm going to do some arithmetic and stuff, and I'll draw out some flow charts. And 6 years from now, we'll revisit this and see what the landscape looks like to see if this can be done. That's called paralysis from analysis, where you do so much stuff, you can't even keep up, and it gets overwhelming. So you want to avoid that. Let's see. I had lemonade and thanks. Here's a good one. Let's see. Andy Mercel. I added lemonade, and thanks to the hot temps, it has made up almost half of my net income at the farmers markets. See that right there? That's what I'm talking about. And you're going, farmers markets. I could tell you so many stories about farmers market. We had a vendor worked his butt off for a year and couldn't get a location to make enough money to leave his full-time job. Okay, and he was vending any day he got off early or whatever he could. And eventually, he set up at a farmer's market and killed it. His first weekend, it was several thousand dollars. I want to say $6,000. I got a whole article on where I interviewed him and everything. And he did that in Missouri. His name's John Cavanaugh. It was the Dancing Dog. And guess what he was doing off his cart, off his big dog cart? He was doing lobster rolls at a farmer's market, and it killed it. People were buying them left and right, and he ran out the first day. So there's so much you can do. So thanks for sharing that, though, Andy, because farmer's markets do great. Look at this right here. Look at this. Scott Painter. And look at Scott's logo. Can you see his logo there? It says Quenchers. Do you see how sexy that is? That's professional and that's sexy. I've always liked that. Awesome, Andy. I hit the record sales for my lemonade last week. It's a great feeling. You got people in here that are doing it. And you could be following them and kind of get an idea. I don't mean go where they are and follow them around. I'm saying you could just be following them on their social medias, their tweeters and stuff. Okay, look here. Here's another one. Eva says, I wanted to do lemonade here in Panama City, Florida, but there are several red flags and hoops to jump through after the Hurricane Michael. Yeah, they're still cleaning up from Hurricane Michael. I have my first cousin is the police chief for Panama City Beach, and then there's him. So whatever that is. Panama City is still cleaning up after the effects of Hurricane Michael. But you can work around it and work with them and go talk to them. But guess what? I talked to a guy this morning who is facing the worst. He's had so many hurdles to face in his state. His state is just idiotic. And he's been, and especially the county he's in, and he's just bulldozing through it. He's doing one red tape, cutting another one. I'm getting through this no matter what. Nothing's going to stop my dream. And the cool part is, it's a once and done thing. So once he's done with that red tape crap, it's over and behind him. But what it does is prevent others from getting in because they hit that border or that wall or that obstacle and they're like, oh no, this is too much. Let me tell you this. I don't have this pulled up. I'll just tell you off memory. This was this morning. And he said, he goes, I just found a card in my state that was a new cart. It wasn't one of mine, but it was a new cart being sold that had never been used, okay? But it was for $1,300. $1,300. You can't buy the stainless steel for $1,300. So he called her and asked, what's going on? There's so much red tape and stuff, it ain't worth the trouble. And so she's basically going to lose $3,000 or $4,000 to sell this used cart that she bought, or the new cart she bought, and sell it cheap, $1,300, because she doesn't want to do the red tape. While there's another vendor in her town, okay, because she's at the she's at the coast, and it's not really the coast. You've got, it's Lake Michigan. So she's in a town that's on the lake. And if she was to vend there, she'd make thousands of dollars, because there is a vendor there, and he does about $10,000 a week. $10,000 a week. Because he bulldozed through the red tape. He jumped the hoops and crossed his T's and dotted I's twice and permanent markered and did whatever they told him to do. And he did it all. It took him a couple months to get it done, or three or four maybe. But he, either way, he's doing it, and it's paying back to him. And that's the difference between the people that really kick butt. And I know there's a lot of easy states where it's easy to get in. But if you don't already have the mindset as, I'm going to do this, and I'm going to do it, and I'm going to make myself get up on Saturday morning when I ain't got to, and go down there to the farmer's market, and I'm going to rake me in a cool $3,600 today. And you go, you know what, I think I'll just stay home. There's some Oprah reruns that I ain't seen, and I might need to catch up on them. And my neighbor's chicken's having puppies, and I'd hate to miss that. You know, there's always an excuse. Those people typically don't stay in the business long. So it's the entrepreneurs that make it. So Eva, keep pressing forward. How's that for a response? That's ridiculous, ain't it? I am a talker. So Eva, just do it. Just do it. It's worth it. Kia says, I was looking at the flea market. Yay or nay? Flea markets kick butt. I've got a video on it. I've got lots of vendors with videos on it. As far as I've done it. My daughters did it. Back when my daughters, this will give you an idea how long ago this has been. The oldest one is 31 now. The one right under her is 26 or 27. That's horrible, isn't it? And they were at the flea market, and they kicked butt their first day. I want to say it was like $1,100 and something. It's like $1,121. I've got it in my book. Anyway, they were tickle pink, thought they were rich. Okay. One said, I don't need to work anymore. I'm rich now. I mean, she literally thought she was rich. Now, this was back when they were, you know, younger, you know, 15, 16 area. But it was cool as crap. So yes, flea markets definitely work. And if you've watched my stuff with Chef Jose, if you go to, I'm going to give you another link. I know this will drive you crazy. LearnHotDogs.com/broke. Or just go to LearnHotDogs.com and type in Jose. See, that's the redneck spelling of Jose. J-O-S-E. Thank you for those thumbs ups. Whoever just did that, that was awesome. If you go to, just type in J-O-S-E. It will pull up all his videos he sent me that he did. He started at a flea market with no license because he didn't have to, in Florida, in Central Florida, at a flea market, and filmed the whole thing. And I think he made a little less than 500 his first day. And then the second day did a little over 1,000. And then the third day over 3,000. So that gives you an idea, with freaking lemonade and hot dogs. And he had no cart, and he had nothing fancy but some tables, and he was using the commissary at the restaurant at the flea market for his license. They allowed him to do that. He paid him a fee. Bottom line is, yes, you can. Let's see. DTN, professional. Window cleaning. Hey, what's going on? Got a second job to start to save and buy a hot dog cart. Absolutely, DTN. And here's the cool thing. You don't have to start with a cart. Follow what Craig just did, or start. Look, I have videos and step-by-step tutorials on how to start without a cart. You ain't got to have a cart, okay? Don't spend the money if you don't have to. And don't put yourself in a bind just to get a cart. I know the cart makes it feel more real. It's kind of like once you get your business card, you feel like, okay, now I'm in business. You could have already been set up IRS with your corporate name. You could have got a trademark and all that. But until you got a business card, I ain't in business. And it's something in our heads that we're like that. I'm the same way. I start a business and I want my dang business card. Now I'm in business. Got a card here. Cost me 3 cents. So don't feel like you got to have a cart. You don't have to have a cart to make this happen, okay? Let start off on a low budget and let it buy your cart, just like Craig, just like Chef Jose, I mean, there's a ton of them. If you go to learnhotdogs.com, instead of putting /lemon, put /broke, B-R-O-K-E, you will see all the people that have been doing this and have done it with a crock pot and a card table even. I'm telling you, and legally, there's legal ways to do certain things in certain states, and I'll walk you through that and how to suss out that information. That's my phone. I'm sorry. I got a rooster ringtone. Tells you just how big of a hillbilly. Okay, so anyway, I do pulled pork and chicken cordon bleu off my hot dog cart on a regular along with lemonade is a great combo. Look at that right there. That's I have no idea. Hannesick? 21. All right. Thanks for sharing that. That is good news. At Hanks. All right. Thanks for sharing that. And see that's something. See in their state, they are allowed to do chicken cordon bleu from a cart. I wasn't allowed to do that. Sherry, you're welcome. Double T, what's up? James Miller. Says, I have a cart, I am 10. And I believe this is the James Miller we have a video of. And that his dad sent me. And I shared it with y'all and I put it on the blog at Learn Hot Dogs. That is no joke. That's a kid who was raising money. If I'm not mistaken, because it doesn't tell me, because I'm sure there's other James Millers, but... James Miller says he got his cart from me. Okay, now here's the deal. He's set up in front of his dad's business and making money. He's even taking money and funding mission trips for the church with his cart. And I believe, James, if I'm not mistaken, you have a Cater Pro, right? And so, and he's doing it all. He had the freaking news station come out and film him. 10 years old. 10. Okay? I didn't even have to take off my shoes to count that high. Let's see. There it is. Hank's Cart and Catering, Pennsylvania. Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. That's who we were talking about just a second ago. Yep, there it is. James Miller. So anyway, y'all can find that at learnhotdogs.com if you want to see a 10-year-old kick butt with this. I did an interview with a I think he was 10 or 11, 12. Years ago in Florida, his parents would drive him down to his location, set up his cart, and come back and get him in 3 hours. And he paid for, he was saving up for his car for when he was 16, but he was paying for his games, video games, and all kinds of stuff, his school clothes, all with his own business. So, pretty neat opportunity. And I wish that I had found this when I was 10. An awesome feeling to be an entrepreneur at 10. Anyway, I love y'all. I wish you the best. I hope you have a fantastic day and a great weekend. And you can always reach out to me and talk to me. I try to get to everybody's comments, and answer those and send you links or wherever I need to send you. If you need anything at all, just holler back and let me know. Let's see. I think that's it. I'll talk to you later.